When I was asked by Lenovo to review their latest ThinkPad and use it to show off some of these game launches, I was so excited that I woke up. After getting out of bed, I decided that maybe it's time to upload again. It's been a while and I'm sorry for that. If you don't want to hear my apology, you want to hear the best way to unify your game collection, dammit. Well, here are the ways. Before we start, I want to clarify that if you use Linux, there are solutions similar to these. However, the only one that works on this list on Linux is Steam. Something like Lutris should be good. One of the easiest options would be to just add your games to one of your already existing game libraries. Steam, Origin, and Battle.net all have this feature, so you don't need to download any other software. Just add your games and you're good. The problem with this solution is that these launchers weren't meant for curating all your games. It's just a feature on the side that Valve made when they were bored and EA and Blizzard copied to be more like Steam. Unlike other launchers in this list, these launchers won't scan your existing game library or give them metadata automatically. It's up to you to add images and add games when you download new ones. And good luck trying to add Game Pass games. That is impossible. Next up is GOG Galaxy. Made by CD Projekt Red, GOG is a platform for buying DRM-free games, meaning you don't need a launcher or internet connection to launch your games, and you actually own them. GOG Galaxy is the optional launcher for GOG, but with the 2.0 release, they made it a great solution for putting all your games from every platform in one place. Just link your game accounts and you're ready to go. GOG Galaxy will do all the metadata for you, and for most platforms, you can even initiate game downloads, but most of the time that involves just opening the launcher to that game. It works with Xbox Game Pass games, and it's very easy to add your own games that might be DRM-free and don't have a launcher. You can even chat with your friends across different game platforms. GOG Galaxy, however, is not very customizable. Along with that, there isn't any equivalent to a Steam Big Picture mode, which I actually use a lot, and you can't really customize your game's metadata. You'll also need a GOG account, and you have to link your accounts, no matter what. GOG is a great pickup and play library, but if you love having full control over your library, you want my last option. So, without further ado, this is the best way to unify your PC game collection. This is PlayKnight. PlayKnight is fully open source, has a wide variety of themes for you to download, and gives you control over everything from the font of the launcher to the games. PlayKnight is also a good pickup and play solution, but it has so many more features compared to the other launchers. I won't even be able to put half of them in this video. PlayKnight doesn't need an account, and if you don't want to see games you don't have installed, you don't even need to log into your game launcher accounts. You can change every single bit of metadata in your games, and you can even import emulators and emulated games. You can make full screen mode look like a different console, and you can still do things that like install games that aren't installed. Adding your own DRM-free games only involves you dragging the desktop icon into PlayKnight and scraping metadata from IGDB with 3 clicks. PlayKnight is what I personally use, and it's amazing seeing my Steam games and Xbox Game Pass games next to my GameCube and PS1 library. PlayKnight is the definitive way to unify your games. Well, honestly, it feels good to make a video again. Maybe I can upload in a week instead of a month. Maybe.